Oh, God.
Hey, guys.
That's how you want to start it?
I'm on new meds today, so this is kind of like an experiment.
All right, so this is Wellbutrin Girlies. We're here.
And, like, don't expose my medication. I want them to think I'm, like, crazier than that.
Okay, that's true. All right, the antipsychotic girlies.
We're okay, chilling. Cut it all.
Very well. Intro.
I'm indulging in a juice box today.
I'm indulging in a Coca-Cola. Good news, guys. I quit nicotine for 3 weeks, and we're back on it. Chester's barking. This is a fucking disaster. Hello, guys. Welcome back to Twin Peaks, episode 5. So, today is Thursday, September 27th. We are recording on this day. We had a lot going on. And the reason I'm telling them that...
It's Thursday the 28th.
That's what I said.
You said the 27th.
Well, I mean... You're on your phone. You're on your phone right now. You're on your phone? You're done? Hello, guys. Welcome back. Twin Peaks, episode 5. Sit up! What the fuck is wrong with you?
Okay, I'm ready.
Let's start. Here we go. Harry Goats.
There she is.
Michael Horse herself.
Yeah.
What is happening here?
His hair was long.
That's the guy.
Gray on gray.
That she visioned.
Yeah, I'm glad they're finally getting to it. That was a while ago, right?
Ugh.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Her presence is eerie.
A gloved hand lifts a rock and takes out a necklace.
Is this fucking play about us?
Wait, is this fucking play about us?
I'm married to your sister now. It's wrong.
Well, you always said you...
Okay.
Jared decided not to kill himself, and he's changed his will, leaving the towers to Jade instead of Emerald, but Emerald found out about it, and now she's trying to seduce Chet to give her the new will so that she can destroy it. Montana's planning to kill Jared at midnight, so the towers will belong to Emerald and Montana, but I think she's going to double-cross him, and he doesn't know it yet.
This is me talking about Twin Peaks to my friends recently.
I love her scrunchie.
Couldn't I spend the night last night?
Will you be having coffee, Deputy Brennan?
What?
Ew.
Gross.
Oh.
Oh. Who's goofier?
Well, one has a menacing aura. This is the difference between a goblin and a ghoul.
Problems of a sexual nature. Agent Cooper, the problems of our entire society are of a sexual nature.
We're big Freud people.
This is Freud.
This is based on Sigmund Freud.
But only as far as Hawaii.
No. That's not right. It's not a V.
No, that is right.
It's Hawaii. You tell me it's Hawaii?
Yeah.
Why?
Jordan, that's racist.
They're not German. There's no way that W's are V's.
That's how it's pronounced.
Hawaii?
Hawaii.
Okay. Well, that's going out. What I did want to say, we're going to start stopping and starting a lot more. I'll have to just suffer through it.
What? We have to stop and start?
Just because I think we should be able to talk.
Yeah. What does that mean? Like, are you going to stay for the morning?
Well, what it means is they've been banging. Well, I'm sure it's actually, like, play dates. But they've been romantically involved. Yeah, those two?
Don't infantilize them.
They are infants. But in the best way possible. Yeah, so that's new.
I don't know if I like it.
I feel like they're a perfect match. I feel like
I know, but like you can't just spring that on me.
Yeah, you gotta have to build it up. But I'm sure like if we go back, it's gonna be one of those things where we've missed things because we just didn't see it coming.
You're probably right.
Also, while we're paused, I wanted to say that woman, the mom, Laura Palmer's mom, for whatever reason, whenever I think of Twin Peaks after Detective Cooper, I think of that mom. I don't know why. Her performance is so memorable. I don't even know if it's like the best. It's really good, but I don't. It's just it's the most memorable. I don't know. I just want to give her. I want to give her.
She always
has little,
like a look on her face.
She's always got something going on.
Dr. Jacoby, I understand you care deeply for Laura Palmer. Why is it that you won't help us?
My own personal investigation, I suspect, will be ongoing for the rest of my life. Laura had.
I haven't seen him investigate anything. I've just seen him sit with a coconut.
Hey, he stalked her grave and then admitted all the guilt in his life.
Who killed her, Dr. Jacoby? The night after Laura died, I followed a man that Laura had spoken to me about. He was driving a red Corvette. I followed him to the old sawmill road and then I lost him. And that gentleman is all I can
do. Oh my god.
Agent Cooper, there's a Gordon Cole on the phone. He says you're expecting a call. Should I put him through?
Yes, Lucy, put him through. Thank you, Doctor.
Why does he look like he's gonna cry?
He's just taking this very seriously.
You'll be in town, Doctor?
Well, I'm planning a pilgrimage.
Pilgrimage.
But that's not till the end of the month.
Ew! He squeezed it. Okay, so, Laura had sex with three people, so now we've known that, but it's kind of like investigation. We have to find out who the three people are. We have the suspects is him, Bobby Briggs, James Hurley. But also, the red Corvette is really interesting. So we got.
So there was a man that she was seeing that drove a red Corvette.
Yeah.
And it went to a windmill.
A windmill. Well, it went to the road. That's obviously a hint. They're pushing us in that direction. So, I mean, it's Mr. Horn, right? A Corvette going towards the sawmill is Mr. Horn, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what they want us to think, at least. All right. 724, 1, 2, 3.
Does Leo Johnson drive a red Corvette?
Yes.
Leo Johnson? How are we doing on our show? It's Leo Johnson. So that goes out the fucking window. God damn it.
Good morning, Gordon. How are we doing?
Cooper, where do we start? The Palmer girl or Albert's new best friend? Truman. Albert has been very busy. The twine he found in her upper arms is a common household variety. Finley's fine twine.
And the twine on her wrists?
Definitely not a match.
Why are you laughing?
That's David Lynch. If I know his weather report videos on YouTube, and I watch those every morning.
Here in L.A., it's raining.
And you tell Albert that if he wants to pursue this, I'll fight him all the way up the train to Washington.
Don't get excited.
I'll talk to you later, Gordon.
He was really acting like 1950s era there.
Yeah, I've
like there
really
was
lot,
some
seen
influences
like
there. I mean, obviously this show has those 50s influences, but his histrionics, very much so.
His hair is so awesome.
Dude, imagine what toll the product must take on that hair.
I had an intuition. Traveling east on Highway 12, how long will it take us to reach the Timber Falls Motel?
Half an hour.
10 minutes.
Depends how you go. Fox found our one-armed
man. Well, let's go 10 minutes. We found the one-armed man. Finally. Joan, get out of there.
Her name's not Joan.
What's her name? Josie. Her actress's name is Joan.
I wish I could. Not even Pete the Poodle knows about that one.
These two are always...
Pete the Porter?
I'm famished.
What did she say?
I don't know. Not that, though. So the one-armed man's at the same motel. Those two are always on the brink of fucking, and it makes me so uncomfortable.
101. Last name is Gerard.
No. When the mill goes up in smoke, the
headline... Oh, they're talking about...
Is Josie Packard torches bankrupt mill.
They're talking about literally burning it down. Okay. That's a big thing. We're going guns blazing. Andy, get that pistol out.
Are they gonna find them?
I don't know. Well, they said they're here for the one-armed man. That would be a big thing. Holy shit.
Did you see his spin?
Dude, yeah, Coop is hilarious, but that actually made my heart drop. Like, I thought someone was about to die. Don't move. Oh, they're hiding his one arm. He's going to reveal it. Put your hand where I can see it.
What do you mean you don't know him? You know this man.
No, sir. I've never seen that hand before in my life. But you know something? Kind of looks like somebody.
They gotta hit him hard, because they're on the hunch of a dream right now.
Why have you been at the hospital the past 2 days?
Bob's in a coma.
There was a Lydecker assaulted 3 days.
Bob's in a coma.
So he does know Bob.
That's Bob.
He does know him then.
That's Bob.
Your friend Bob, a doctor.
He's just that's the best Bob. Parts.
Thanks.
After my uncle.
How'd you lose the arm?
Car accident. I was on the road from Memphis to.
There's definitely a Laura Palmer hand in that briefcase or something.
Nope.
Nope,
just
sorry.
Just a bunch of shoes.
Just a bunch of shoes. My bad. He's a shoe salesman?
Right foot.
It's my second case. Yeah. 2 day delivery guarantee. We could certainly take care of all.
I'm not buying this.
The arm you lost. Did it have a tattoo?
They're not going to ask any questions about the shoe case?
I'm a shoe salesman.
That's the most normal thing. Well, he seems very normal. They're throwing us off.
You won't tell us. We can find out. What did it say?
No, he's...
It said... Bob!
What are they talking about?
His tattoo. He's in love with Bob. And Bob's in a coma.
Wait, it said Bob? I thought he said Mom.
No, Bob. I don't think it's Mom.
The car was already staked out when I got here. It was Josie
Payne. Well,
those
are just...
Wait, what did they say about Josie?
She was there.
How do they know?
Hawks are.
When?
Do we have to show everything?
A tall, dark, and handsome stranger falls madly in love with me, takes me away to a life of mystery and international intrigue.
I'm sorry, Coop is as pale as it gets.
Maybe he'll realize that I'm the woman of his dreams because I'm going to help him figure out who killed Laura.
Is that so?
Yeah. You're going to help me. Fact, Laura was seeing James Hurley.
The white shirt.
What if she was?
So it is true. Fact, Laura had a...
Please stop. Fact.
Rainn Wilson could have gotten this from this. He has all the secrets. He's the safe. He's the safe in the story. You gotta crack it open.
It gets better. You ever heard of One Eye Jacks?
Isn't that Western with Marlon Brando?
It's a place across the border. They have girls working there. Think about Laura being in a place like that, and I get all shivery. But it's like a hot cold, like when you hold an ice cube on your bare skin for a long time.
Don't do that. I don't do that.
Who has ever done that?
Whatever we find out, we have to promise to keep it between ourselves.
Oh.
Our secret. It's a deal. And I know
they're
exactly
going undercover. They're
team.
Boss.
We got a little team going on here. We got
I
a
like
little
it.
Starsky and Hutch. Here we go. Our favorite plot line. I recognize that guy so much. Or maybe he just looks like action stars of the 80s. I don't know.
So what, is he getting out of jail?
Haven't seen you for a while, Norma.
Yeah.
Been kind of busy.
So, business is good?
Yeah.
She's a waitress.
You gotta back me up in there, Norma.
She doesn't own the place, does she?
I don't think so. That'd be...
Starting to put the zap on me big time. Condition goes out of control. A vagrant nobody knows is killed. Why? Why did fate deal me?
He's an order.
You were not incarcerated for an act of fate, Mr. Jennings.
I accept that. But it was fate. Maybe in an odd way, even luck that sent me to prison, just as much as the car accident.
Mrs. Jennings, your husband would be facing a difficult reentry. How would you help him? I own the Double R Diner.
What the fuck?
We're learning something every single day.
Well, here's my husband.
Oh, she's over it.
Well, we have what we need here. We'll make our decision without the inmate present.
Mm. I'll say one thing. David Lynch knows how to introduce a character. A crisp high five. Try not to shoot anybody. I like his hat and his belt. I should do that more. I'm a big hat guy.
I've never seen you wear a belt or a hat.
What?
In the heat of the investigative pursuit, the shortest distance between two points is not necessarily a straight line.
Ms. Loomer, we're going to have to confiscate your file.
What?
Damn.
Hell yeah.
He's on like a warpath today. Yeah,
he's getting this murder solved.
He doesn't care about the little old lady.
We're taking your shit. I gotta love that.
Oh my.
In the place is crazy. Where's and she Leo? Is so hot. I'm sorry. She is. Like, what am I supposed to not? These are two very hot individuals.
Where is Leo?
He is not hot.
I wanted to hold you so much.
Did you see what she said?
James Hurley.
He's with his friend, that creepy Jacques.
Jacques! This is what we asked for.
That Canuck guy that was at the roadhouse.
Me and Jack.
What's the matter?
Oh.
That was kind of a move.
That was a move.
I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
What?
He's so fucking crazy.
He's such a creature.
He's always just like.
He's always like a soda that has been shaken violently. Like, any second he can pop.
We gotta go back.
Yeah.
Leo and Jacques are running drugs across the border. Cocaine. And they've been selling them at school.
And you've been doing it. The gun? That does not apply to what he was talking about. Oh no, the grape shirt.
He went grape picking.
He works at a grape farm.
Shelly, I'm off to stomp grapes.
My favorite blue shirt.
If it's your favorite blue shirt, why'd you get so much grape on it?
Got herself a gun.
She got herself a gun, and she's hiding it. Oh.
With his grape shirt.
With his grape shirt, yeah.
About 2 days after Laura was murdered. What if she thought it was grape juice this whole time?
What is Leo doing at the grape farm?
And he's like, honey, this is blood.
This is blood. Oh my god.
Yeah. Stay clear and keep quiet.
Is he finally going to kill him? He's going to kill him. He's going to act, finally.
She's acting kind of strange.
She likes it. She likes it. She likes all this danger.
That's what she wears to work?
She, like, don't point it towards your head. His name's Dick.
Why does it say that?
I don't know, but she's had such a...
Wait, is Dick short for Bobby?
No, Richard.
Oh. Is Bobby short for Richard?
Bobby's short for anything. I'm gonna start going by Bobby.
Get some ammunition for the lockbox. Meet us downstairs at the pistol range.
Oh, we're teaching. All right, we need this. We need a fun little offshoot where we teach Andy how to shoot a gun, and then.
Did you hear what happened?
Let's get Lucy in there.
So dumb. I dropped my gun and it went off.
Are you all right?
Oh yeah, I guess so. But
I would like to chat, but I am now under orders to examine these files. So if you'll excuse me, please.
You're telling me you don't like this.
I do.
Yeah, I love it.
I don't think we haven't really heard him that much. Like,
No, he's just kind of been hitting the head with things.
Yeah.
All right, a little training montage. Give us a little break here, David.
How long has Lucy been upset with Andy? Body language? In this case, it was yelling through a megaphone.
That's beautiful. Beautiful.
I knew someone once who helped me understand commitment, the responsibilities, and the risks. He taught me the pain of a broken heart.
Oh, he is so fucking cool.
Oh, God.
He's stone cold.
Four hits. Oh, I put four through the eyes and one through each nostril.
Nice pattern.
Agent Cooper, I'm going to get the files from Dr. Lidecker. And I have here in the A's an artist who's a part poodle, part Rottweiler, who lives on Maple and belongs to Mr. Rumpel. Then, for example, I have an Annette, who's an otter, who lives with a family near Elk River.
We wanted the name of birds.
The files are all organized alphabetically.
Lucy, go through the bird file.
What's it?
Oh.
We're gonna need some more coffee.
So it was sexist of us to not think she owned this place, right?
I don't feel like there was anything that indicated she did.
Not a lot. Other than that, her daughter, not daughter, works here.
2 men apiece. So we don't know what to do with any of the four of them.
I love that line.
Donna?
God damn it.
Who the heck ever heard of diet lasagna?
Just a sec, Daddy. I'll be right in, okay? It's James. Hi, we're having this church potluck dinner here tonight.
Well, tell him to get over here. I need help.
Aw.
Okay.
Mayday.
Oh, I love that interaction.
Come? I don't think that'd be very good company.
Yeah, well, I know. I agree.
Are you ever?
I found out something. Audrey told me some stuff that Mrs. Palmer saw.
Oh, yeah. The stalking ghost of Laura Palmer.
I'm gonna get some tea, then I'll be over in a little bit.
I like how nobody notices.
She's so ominous. Like, I feel her presence. I'm sure it's like a point, but... Okay.
Oh.
Can I kiss you?
Aunt Sarah can't cook right now, and Uncle Leland's up half the night listening to old music and crying and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. They got their hands full. I feel like that's the happiest I've seen him.
Yeah,
it was like normal.
Yeah, he didn't act weird at all. Much, as opposed to the jokes I was trying to make, he really handled that well. Can you stop pumping?
I've decided I want to help you with the family business.
I mean, this is just for investigation.
Obviously, it's not going to be Johnny.
Oh,
Audrey. I wish that I could believe you.
Daddy, please let me be your daughter again.
Mm.
I'd let her be my daughter.
I don't know.
She convinced me.
Yeah, well, I agree. We know she's up to things. She has motives.
I mean, she's so pretty.
That's all it takes. Oh, we got a Hitchcock shot.
Ugh. Oh, okay.
Yeah, not my favorite either.
I never really liked them, to be honest.
Well, you have to do it in this show. You're doing a 50s thing.
I like it here.
Yeah.
Why is this such a ominous moment?
Why is she dressed like the nun, too?
Two.
Loris Armstrong, he's a parakeet. Who are the others?
This is so wholesome.
Cooper here.
Coop, Albert is faxing you his
Do you think he's gonna show up? Me.
Oh my god.
Holy shit.
So you're telling me the Tundas people were totally what's the word?
Wait, are they really breaking down Waldo's door right now?
He does not have a parrot, I'll tell you that.
They were looking for Renault. This is cool. Go get him. Yeah. He left the fucking shirt.
Why would he leave it there?
Wait, is this good for them? LJ.
Leo Johnson and Jacques. Well, no, it's just like randomly here.
Leo's like
crosses a lot of wires.
Leo Johnson's like, I knew I shouldn't have stitched my name into all my shirts individually.
Such a narcissist.
It's a nice car.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Score.
Oh my god.
Is he peeing?
So he's here though?
He's the guy Mr. Horn's meeting.
Nice touch, Leo. Nice touch. Bright red sports car for a secret meeting. Don't like it, get somebody else. No, no, no.
What? Jock's back in Canada. This is the fucking accent guy. Told him if he ever did, I'd
kill him. This is Jock's brother?
Yeah, Leo killed him. Shouldn't have trusted. Don't disappoint me. Leo's like a murderer.
Keep it simple. Insurance investigators should read arson. Block letters about 6 feet high. The deal as we discussed. Rest on delivery.
Everyone's in on the arson.
Green light. It's a town effort. Everyone but Josie and the police force. How could she know? She said she saw it. She saw the vision and she saw someone take it. Donna. It's gone. Donna, I've never messed up like this before.
This rock was supposed to be secure.
How could Mrs. Paul? They all have like blue eyes. Keep checking in on the video. Whoa! Eliza, you missed a really cool
thing. Okay, well, that was your fault.
Sorry. Back. The police. She used to see things. She had these dreams.
Laura did too. Oh, damn. Is that Laura?
Yeah, that's Laura reincarnated as Owl. He knows James, the police didn't love
Laura. Nobody loved her but us. Is that true?
I guess so.
I feel like she was James, very beloved.
James is acting good. Sometimes it's like I really do see her. Well, he still has a little bit of that. We're gonna find out who killed her. This is about us. It's about me now. To do this for us, not just for her.
Guys, they really love putting themselves at the center.
I really want to be the main character, James.
James. You're right. I want to be with you. I mean, yeah, we know.
They love smooching at inappropriate times and places.
It's usually at that one place.
Yeah. What the fucking be prepared is that? Can you just help me find? Be prepared. This lesson must be shared. This lesson must be shared. Be prepared. Be prepared. Be prepared. And unless you got...
No one's gonna understand.
I'm gonna put in a clip. I feel like he has a quota. He just has to be in every episode, but have nothing to do.
Makes him kind of sus. I made you a horse.
She thinks it's literal. She finally gets an expression right. And he's like, very good. And then she brings out a horse head. This year, well, they're adding a mixed double division. Everyone seems a little looser this episode. Don't you think?
Yeah. I think that has a lot to do with the bird investigation, though.
Well, like these two. I think the whole episode has this looser aura. We're hitting its stride. Sure, Pete. Let's give
give it the run at the money.
There we go.
Look at this, Jordan.
Hank.
Yeah.
Hank. Hank.
Why would he draw her that?
He drew her that?
Drove her?
He drew her that?
Ah! Well, it was a drawing, and I'm not... I guess I was assuming that he drew it, but...
Mm-hmm. He's still connected? Ew. Hello. How is she mixed up with him? I guess him and Ari Trum kind of have a vibe going on. A similar vibe, but like yin and yang. Like... Mm-hmm. Good and bad.
Like evil twin.
Yeah, that's his evil twin. Just like how the psychiatrist is Cooper's evil twin. That's Troom's evil twin. Thanks for watching, guys. Episode 6 will be out soon. And also, Eliza, you have to ask a question. Because I asked a question about war and I got really good answers. So this is how, you have to do like a girly question. Whatever girls like.
Excuse me?
Girls can like war too.
Girls love war, famously.
I love war now. I can't get enough of war.
What was your favorite Disney star and why?
Disney star?
Mm-hmm. No. Okay. What was your favorite Disney star drama? For example, Demi Lovato overdoses on heroin.
She didn't. That wasn't heroin. It was cocaine.
No, it's her.
Also, we don't know the age. I think our viewers are older. They like Twin Peaks. All right, let's give an alternative. Well, not Disney. It doesn't have to be Disney.
Okay.
All right. What is your favorite young pop actress / star actor? Overdose. What's your favorite celebrity overdose that they survived?
And why was it your favorite? Is it because of the actual events? Because the moral of the story?
I think we should do this again. I don't think we should put this in at all.
Why?
You're right. It's good. Cut.
Is that insensitive?
What's your favorite overdose?
Is it actually?
It's going in. I don't care. I'm the one who said it.
If I had more time to think about it, I would probably say it's insensitive.
We're putting it in. But it's fucking hilarious. What's your favorite overdose? And that was like what a girl question for girlies. This girl pop girls. Question trivia. What was your favorite overdose and why?
Okay.
Wait, should we change it? Should we change it to just like, what is your favorite drug addiction?
No.
No, we gotta go all out. We gotta go overdose.
Favorite drug addiction?
No, favorite like person who was addicted to drugs in this man. They don't have to have overdosed.
No.